Straight to an NDTV exclusive. Even as the CBI probes the alleged irregularities in coal block allocation, former coal secretary PC Parakh, during whose tenure coal blocks were awarded, has told NDTV that the process was prone to corruption and companies lobbied to get allotments in their favour, also admitting that a shift to a bidding system was resisted at that point. Let's go across to Srinivasan Jayan for those exclusive details. Vasu, you've of course spoken to the former coal secretary. How significant is his admission at this point?
His admission is extremely significant because, as you mentioned, Secretary during 2004-2005, when the government was actively considering switching from the existing system of a screening committee process of selection to a more transparent tariff-based competitive bidding system. Now, that process took almost 8 or 9 years to complete, during which time hundreds of coal blocks were allotted, which has formed the nucleus of what we call the coal scam. So PC Parakh, who was as coal secretary, the chairman of the screening committee, was in the best position to actually see what was going on. His comments have already been made part of the CAG report into the entire controversy. And now for the first time, he's given us an interview on camera where he said that there was clear instances, or he believed at least that there was a clear scope for corruption in the manner in which these coal blocks were allotted through the screening committee. He says that there were pulls and pressures on the committee from all members, including the state governments, as well as the various ministries, whether it was power, whether it was iron and steel or cement, who he said were, in quotes, sponsoring various companies to get certain coal blocks. And he said that the best system would have been to switch to the competitive tariff-based system, which didn't happen. Let's listen in first to PC Parakh before we talk more about this. This is what he had to say, speaking to us from Hyderabad a short while ago.
Well, the point is, in any system of distribution which is not based on competitive bidding, you are bound to get a variety of pressures. And no human beings can be absolutely objective in deciding when you know there are many, many subjective considerations which come into picture. So there were two reasons for me to propose this change. One is that we had a good number, large number of applicants and less number of coal blocks. And the second was that, there will be all kind of pressures coming on the screening committee. Because you have too many people, then naturally everybody will try to influence through various quarters in his favor. So once you have a competitive bidding, you neither face pressures and you also have a very transparent system of distribution.
Right, Vasu, so we of course heard the former coal secretary there clearly saying that the screening committee was not really that transparent. The shift to a bidding system was resisted. What exactly will his admission mean then to the CBI probe that is underway?
Well, it'll be very significant because the CBI is obviously trying to go back to talk to all the key players at that time, as well as look at all the documentation from that period to see if there was, in fact, corruption or was this a failure of policy. And so PC Parakh's admission that, where on one hand he talks of pulls and pressures, which is a more indirect way of suggesting that there were other motivations which led to people in that committee lobby for certain companies, and then in a more direct question by us, which we'll also play for you later, where I asked him, do you believe that in this process there was corruption? And he said, yes, I have no reason to believe otherwise. That will form a very important part of the CBI's attempts to try and reconstruct what happened. Also, very quickly, it's significant because at that time, the coal ministry came under the Prime Minister's office, and therefore the extra heat on the government by those who claim that the PM was somehow directly or indirectly overseeing all of this. Now, PC Parakh does point out that the Prime Minister was very keen to move towards a more transparent system, but he said that for various reasons, again, having to do with political pressures, that didn't happen. So again, his comments on the PM's role, or rather the fact that the PM actually wanted to switch towards a more transparent system, will also be significant.
Right, Srinivasan Jayan, many thanks for getting us those details. And as Vasu pointed out, of course, let's get in former coal secretary also talking about, irrespective of the system you devise, you are, of course, giving a sizable asset free, of course, when it comes to the allocation process.
No, irrespective of what system you devise, when you are giving a sizable asset free of cost, then there will be many rent seekers in between who will try to get pie, part of this pie. Yes, I did do that. No, all my notings on the file very clearly indicate that unless we introduce a transparent system, wrong things can happen. No reaction in the sense that nobody at, the PMO and the Prime Minister definitely were supportive of the proposal, but then ultimately nothing actually happened. That's the point. Nobody disputed the point that this will be the transparent and best method of going about.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? All the markets, all the news in your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.